Hello YouTubers, subscribers, and friends. Well, we've been getting rain for about a week now, and since it rains, all the critters come out. I found this new ant pile right here. They're little black ants right here. And then I found another ant pile right here that are different. No, these ones are little black ants too. And there's a third pile right here. These are big red ants. And because of the rainy weather, and I got these little bitty ants right here, three piles. Actually, six piles. There's six piles. And then there's a huge snake skin right here. That's the second one I found in the yard. And then there's either 6, 7, 8, 9. This is the 10th ant pile right here. These are big black ants. I just want to set my camera back a little bit and watch them. So I got a mission today. I'm going to kill all these ants with my Indonesian ant poison called Kapur Ajiab. I get a lot of people emailing me asking me where they can buy this stuff, and unfortunately they don't sell it here in the States. You'll have to get it from Indonesia, and there's no place on the internet to buy this stuff. Ooh, trying to get it on my feet. So I'm just gonna do some filming. I got a brick right here. Put my camera on so I can watch these ants. I have to watch where I'm standing. Ooh, get it on my feet. I don't want to get bit. I put that brick down there and they start going wild over here. Different views of different ants. Okay, getting on the brick. Attacking my camera. I'm going to kill all these ants. And be done with them. Ant carrying a feather over here. It's a huge feather. I'm going to show you this ant carrying this feather. I don't know what he needs that feather for. I'm gonna put him over here with the black ants. I hate ants. Let go of the feather. Let's go see these other ants over here. Let's remove these bushes here. You get a better view of these ants here. Gotta watch my feet. They're trying to bite me. Ouch. Some kind of thorn I stepped on. It's Gotta be careful in the desert wearing flip-flops. Tiny little black ants. It's weird because when it's cloudy like this in the rain weather, these ants, they act really different. Look at all this stuff. This is the stuff they brought out of their anthill. I don't know what it is. It's that plant. It's this plant right here. These plants here. This is what it looks like when it's all put together. I don't know why it's like that. There's a rabbit over there. Let me look around if there's any more anthills around here. It's definitely I'm gonna show you this snake over here that I found in my driveway a couple weeks ago, and I put over here by the prairie dogs. Have not seen the prairie dogs in a while. This snake has been sitting out in the sun. And this is how it's decomposing. It's drying up. Sitting out here in the sun for a couple weeks. But let's kill some ants. I'm gonna get my Kapur Ajiab and make a powder, and then I'm gonna spread it on all these ant piles. I don't see any more around here. My neighbor lady's peeking at me out her door, nosy. Call her Mrs. Kravitz because she wants to know everything. Anyways, let me get this brick. And start putting some poison on these anthills. The black ants have the same stuff. They have that bush on the outside there. I don't know what that is. Take a look at these little red ants. These are the tiny, tiny, tiny little red ants. And I've never seen them before in my driveway. So I'm going to kill them too. And there's a lot of ants going this way. I don't know where they're going. Let's follow, see if I can find another pile somewhere around here. Going this way. There they are. Gotta be another pile around here somewhere. I've not seen any prairie dogs, like I said, in a while. I don't see any other ant piles except this little bitty one. Right here. I killed a lot of ants. I didn't have any ants. And now, like I said, we've been raining for about a week. These ants have been coming out. I don't know. Maybe the prairie dogs have been rained out. And they're doing repair work or something. That's why they haven't been coming out. It's very strange. No snakes or rabbits in there. Alright, well, let me get my ant poison prepared and commence to go to war with these ants again. Haven't seen the horny toads in a while either. Put my brick back where it goes. Let me see over here. Usually I have I got ants over here too. I'm gonna have to put some more over here. So that's about what, 12, 13 ant piles? Maybe the big crevice cavern they made in there. Well, I'm gonna get my poison. Get rid of these up. Okay, I got my Kapur Ajiab here. You want to make sure when you handle this stuff that you have some gloves. I'm going to take it out of the package here. And so it looks like chalk. It's not chalk, it's a really strong poison. I'm going to grind it up into this lid here, which I put tape over to cover this hole. I got me a spoon so I can dip in there and I can spread it around. So let me get that all prepared and then I'll be back. Okay, once you get this bag cut open, you want to take this chalk out of the bag. And just be careful, don't get it on your face or anything. Looks like chalk. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to grind it like this. I'm just going to try to make a powder. Oops, that broke off. Make a powder here so I could sprinkle it onto the end piles. Normally, you get this chalk and it kills spiders, ants, roaches, whatever. Normally, if you do it in your house, you would just do a line. Wherever you got ants or bugs coming into your house, you draw a line around the area where you want to kill the bugs. Because this is for indoor use. But I want to make a powder because I want them to think it's food and to be able to eat it and put it in their mouth and carry down to the food supply. And plus, its powder gets onto their bodies and it will kill them too. If they try to clean their bodies, they will get it in their mouth and clean it too. See, I'm making a pile there because there's so many ant piles that I found. And like I said, just a week ago, they weren't even there. So, time to kill all these ants again. And it's weird, they're different. They're big black ants, they're big red ants, they're little red ants, and they're little black ants. So it's like four different kinds of ants in one area. So, I don't have any in my backyard. I killed all the ones in my backyard, they've never come back. I want to make sure I make a big pile here. So I'm going to work on this and then I'll sprinkle it on the ant pile. Okay, I got me a nice little pile right here. And you can see I didn't really use maybe a quarter piece of the full stick there. Not too much. I made that much of a pile. So now I'm going to go and sprinkle this onto the ants. Let's start over here. Let's make sure I get everybody. So, let's put this down. Let's move this stick out of the way. And what you want to do is you want to get down in the hole as much as possible. That, but more so where they have to walk through this stuff. Actually, I'm doing a lot here. You don't have to do that much, but let's go to the next ant hole. And you can see it gets onto the ant and they carry it down in the hole. When you mess with these ants, you feel like everything's crawling on you. And let's go over here, kill this pile over here. Even though it's not near my house, I'm gonna kill it anyways. Where did I see it? It was smaller. I lost it. Here it is right here. Very small pile there. Just put a little bit. Overkill. You can see him dying already. Let's go kill some more smaller piles. And it's walking everywhere on the ground. Alright. I I don't know if ants can scream, but these ants all around here are all running around extra wild now since I put that powder on there. So I don't know if there's an ant cry that only ants can hear, but these ants are going nuts running around the area here. There's a big ant digging in the little ant's pile. Okay, I just finished sprinkling all the powder on all the ant piles. I walked around my property. I live on an acre of property and I found 5 more, so I got a total of 16 ant piles. I made up another batch of Kapur Ajiab. As you can see, I used about half of a stick of the chalk. These are 3 inches long. And I just finished putting it on and I noticed, I gotta go get my other camera because my battery died. I noticed all the little ones are dead. All the ants on the little piles, they're dead. There's no movement. Look at this lizard. Oh, he's trying to walk by me all cool. And I turn around and he hauled ass. Where is he? He's a long one, man. He's about 6 inches long. Anyways, I noticed that the red ants are a lot stronger than the black ants. Here's the one black ants here. They're dying. They go off and they start shaking. Oops. Sorry about that. They start shaking right before they're going to die. So what they do is they run away from the hole and then they die. The red ants, oh man, I put an extra amount on them because these suckers are tough. They're not even showing any signs of dying. It's like, I don't know, man. This stuff just, although I did see some die, it's just, they're really tough, these red ones. I never dealt with, oh, they got a back door over there I didn't even see. I'm gonna have to hit that one. Anyways, that's where they take the feathers in. This pile right here, you can see all the dead ones around the whole pile. This thing was covered with ants. You can see them down in there shaking. It's 9:30 in the morning. I started at 9:15. You can see how fast this starts working. I found another one, a little one right over here. And they're dead. There's none around that one at all. And then this other big one over here had all the crap around it. You can see all the dead ants around it. Got some workers still working here. There's some dead ones in here. But yeah, they're gonna die. Come back in a couple hours and we'll see what happens. This is a really big one. I got some more over there in the front of the property that I'm not too much worried about, but yeah, I'm gonna put some here on this back door. Right there. Dump some down in there. Well, oh, we got one more to check over by my shed over here. Killing ants. I hate ants, but I love to kill them. Bit of war. Yeah, every time it rains, I come out with these critters all the time. Brandy! That's my dog, Brandy. Lucy! Lucy! Who's the pretty girls, huh? Who are the pretty girls? Give kisses. Give kisses. Brownie, give Josie kisses. Give kisses. Josie hates getting kisses from Brownie. All right, well, the movement on this one has slowed down. You can see right here. This one was pretty busy when I started. They're slowing down. See down in that crevice there? Oops. Slowing down. They'll die. I'll come back later and show you some results. Alright, I just finished eating my breakfast. It's 10 after 10. I finished putting the powder about 9:30. As you can see, this is the one by my shed, by my dogs. There is no ants anywhere in this area. There is no movement. anywhere. So I'm pretty much happy about that. I mean, this Kapur Ajiab kills these ants so fast. It's just amazing. The little ant piles don't even stand a chance. And supposed to get rain today, and there's not a cloud in the sky. And come over here to this pile here. I don't even see any ants anywhere on the ground over here. As you can see here, got a scraggler there. But this pile was the first pile that I showed at the beginning of the video. I put the camera down and it was pretty busy. There's a dead one right there. And just within, I don't know, 40 minutes, it's killing these ants off pretty quick. Like I said, the little ants, little red ants. There was red ants running around everywhere. There's one there. There's none in the holes. No movements anywhere in these holes where the powder is. And the ground area, there was a trail going that way. I followed the trail to the ant pile over there. Those are dead. There's no ants here. There's some scragglers coming from this direction. And here's a red one right here. He's dying. That's what that's how they act right before they die. There's another one. Although the red ants, oh, one on my leg. Although the red ants are much tougher than the black ants. They've cleared out a lot of the powder. I put an extra amount of powder on there. I see some dead ones around the body. Oh, coming. Oh, they're coming at my feet. But, oh, it's on my foot. Man, they're quick. I'm about 5 feet away from the ant hole and they're still attacking me. Those ants are tough. This other ant pile here, gone. Nothing. There's nothing running around. There's a scraggler there. He's dying. There's one dying right over here. There's one over there dying. But there's still a lot of powder there. So if there's any left in there that are still alive, they come out, they're going to get in. They're going to die. If there's any that are coming from their walkabouts, coming back to their hole, they're going to find dead ants there. My battery's flashing on this battery too. Going to die. But here's the ant pile over here. They had the craft around it. You can see right there, this was pretty wild and a bunch of them running around. Barely any movement. I mean, there's some over there dying. Some over here dying. But yeah, 40 minutes. It's killed off a whole lot of ants. So this stuff works pretty good. They're getting on my feet now. They're attacking me. There was a little pile over, or was it over here? Little ant pile. They were dead before I went in the house. As you can see, there's no movement around here whatsoever. There's one little straggler, one little bitty red ant there. All around here, there's dead bodies over here. So those are dead. They'll be dead. 40 minutes, that's how quick this Kapur Ajiab works. And before I went in, I found a back door on this ant pile. Where'd it go? Over here. The feathers are. So I'm gonna have to keep an eye on these red ants. They're really tough, man, because this is the back door. This was completely covered. I doused it. Overkill. Here's one dying right here. He's dying. So it does kill the red ants, but they seem to be a little bit stronger than the black ants. But I'm pretty sure if I come out in an hour and they're still moving like this, I'm gonna hit them with another pile of powder. But yeah, they're going off that way somewhere. Kapur Ajiab. It's really strong, works really, really good. I'm gonna go over here if I can see an ant pile, because I can't keep the ants from coming on my property completely, but I can kill them when they do get here. I don't see any over here. But I got my next door neighbor. She's got a bunch of ant piles. I can see them. And you know, if there's no ants over here and you got these scouts that come out looking for a new place, you know, they don't find any ants on my property, they'll make new homes. But all the ant piles that I put powder on, I counted 16 of them. All of them showing no movement to very little movement. This is the only pile here that's still showing a very active amount. And like I said, they have cleared the powder. I mean, I had a huge pile there. I put an extra amount on them. So I know they've... They either took it because they thought it was food, or they took it and they cleared it up and moved it out somewhere else. But anyways, they're going to die. because that's the only one that has a lot of movement on it. I'll be back in an hour, and if they're still there, I'll put more on them. But there you have it, killing ants, my war with ants. Here's the guy, he's coming back from a long trek carrying a feather. It's like a, I don't know, dragonfly wing or something, and he's gonna come to a rude awakening. He's gonna get home, he's like, what the hell happened here? He's going to that hole. There's one dying right here. This one's got wings. That's one I was pouring in the back door area. As I was pouring the powder in, one came flying out of there, an ant with wings, and this one, he's dying. Got wings on. Sucker face. Oh, my battery's flashing. It's dying on this camera too. So there you have it, killing ants. Again, the ant war continues, but I'm going to win with Kapur Ajiab. Now I'm going inside. It's hot out.